nice of you.
Ben évidemment, c'est ici où les fans rencontrent les Backstreet Boys juste avant qu'ils montent sur la scène. Tout ça, c'est vraiment. Mais voilà qu'avec tout en bien. Et dis bonjour à tout le monde. Bye, Kev. Have a good one. Don't leave, eh? I'm coming at you, okay? Hi, bye, Brian. Have a good show.
Okay, I will.
Okay. Voilà, on va aller retrouver les membres des familles des Backstreet Boys qui sont présents pour la première fois pour les voir sur scène. Venez avec moi. Sur la scène, une dernière photo avec toute la gang des Backstreet Boys. Puis ça, c'est vraiment hot parce que ça, ça va être un souvenir inoubliable. Là, ils montent littéralement sur la scène et puis on va rencontrer les membres de la famille. C'est ce qu'on appelle, mesdames et messieurs, du live.
I told you I would have a good show.
Okay, Brian. On a été chanceux au Québec parce que ça a été vraiment la place choisie par la formation des Backstreet Boys pour réunir leur famille pour la première fois, donc en compagnie de Mrs. Richardson et Mr. and Mrs. Luttrell, qui sont ici évidemment la mère de Kevin et les parents de Brian. It is so nice to have you here. You know, we have blabbed and followed those boys around more times than I can remember. I just want to know, Mrs. Luttrell, what was your reaction last night when you saw them in such a huge venue?
I was so overjoyed. It was so wonderful. We've never seen them perform on quite that level. It's so wonderful to see such a diversity of ages loving their music, because we love their music, and we love to see them get to do what they love to do. So it was just wonderful.
Now, I know Dad said that he didn't want to talk much, but I just got to ask you a question. Can I, Mr. Luttrell? Please, please. When I spoke to Brian, you tell me if you like the quote. When I spoke to Brian last and we did an interview, he said that a lot of his humor comes from you, that you had great friends who made him laugh and great friends have made you laugh. Is that true?
That is true, yes.
Yes,
yes, ma'am, it is. I like to be a ham sometimes, so I guess he got that from me, some of it anyway. And then my wife's got a couple of brothers. They ham it up, too.
Does this surprise you to see this success, or did you always know that he had it in him to do what he's doing right now?
I felt like all of the boys have a God-given gift, and it takes all of them together to make it happen. And they are very cautious to give give their very best. They work very hard at being very professional, and they're very fun-loving and very big-hearted. And I think that comes over in their music and the image they convey. And we did, yes. I think we all knew they'd be successes because they're a success at life in general.
Mrs. Richardson, it must be great for you guys as well to know that they're first cousins and here they are, they're traveling together and working together. What were your feelings? What was the emotion that was felt last night seeing them on stage?
Well, I'm just so very proud of all of the boys. We care for all of them, and it takes like all of them to make the Backstreet Boys, and them loving and caring, and we're just one big family.
Kevin is a very special soul. When I interviewed him, you could tell that he's very meticulous. He really wants everything to be really as close to perfect as humanly possible because he wants to give his fans the best. Where does that come from? Where has he learned that?
Yeah, you're saying Mrs. Richard?
From me and maybe his grandmother. And I think all that you put into the lives of others comes back into your own.
You're here with your other sons, and I know that they feel great pride watching them on stage. I just want to know what you feel for the boys in general, what this means to you to be here and sharing in this kind of success.
It's just really awesome. And they're all special. All three of my sons are, and they're all talented, and they're all part of their father and our love. And we're just so proud of all three of them, whatever they undertake.
I know that Kevin would have loved to have had his dad with us here, and he's passed on, but we all really believe that he is here somewhere, somehow. He's watching.
Kevin Dance is having a good time tonight. If there was one piece of advice that you could give the boys after seeing them perform and seeing what they are going through, what would you say to them that you would never want them to forget, a lesson in life?
God. Because they can't do it in their own strength. It's very hard work. And they need a lot of wisdom, a lot of courage, and things that this world can't give them. Only their inner spiritual strength from God.
When you saw them last night for the very first time in the Molson Center, I mean, with the adoring fans all around, was that what you expected, or was it even bigger than you suspected?
It was bigger than I thought. Yeah, definitely.
What wish do you have for them?
The kids love them so much. That's the best thing.
What piece of advice would you give Kevin right now at this point in his career?
To appreciate every minute that he gets. To appreciate every bit of it.
Can you believe what you're saying?
Unbelievable. It's incredible.
And do you think that you will be able to actually describe this?
No way. Just look around you.
Évidemment, c'est juste avant d'aller sur scène pour les Backstreet Boys ce soir. Je pense qu'ils savent que c'est l'hystérie qui les attend, donc on veut juste leur souhaiter bonne chance. Have a great show, guys!
I told you I was going to have a good show. And what might you be doing?
I have no idea.
Security! Just joking. She's a VIP. Very important person.
Okay. So the closer you are to the screen,
that's also the reason why you had all that time. Remember we thought there was a dead space there? That's why, because they had it prepared for us. Get underneath
all that. On the lip.
On